and I'll be back.
I think we'll make it.
All right. The combat done. I'm going to check the Sturges to see if they've got anything. Cool.
Oh, the combat?
You're twitching right now.
Yeah, I'm restarting it if I can bring it back up. But
they're all dead.
Okay. Bathroom. I'll be right back to them.
Did you say you're going to check the Sturges?
I want to see if they could just, like, if they ate anything interesting. I don't know.
Check the bodies, Blackjack says.
You check the bodies, including cutting stuff, but you think interesting.
Then I stones.
You find rusted point because it's been.
Now that I've moved forward, more, can I see what's on my?
Oh, here.
Stream's back up. Sorry about that. I think it cut out.
That is a path up.
Twitch is being weird tonight.
That is a path down.
We killed all the Sturges. They're all dead now.
Up a little. Two. Okay. As you check the skeletons, you don't end up not finding anything on them that would be worth anything taking. It's very obvious from what you're looking at that basically these guys killed each other. The dwarf and humans, mostly dwarf, were fighting the orcs. And there's a lot more dwarf and humans than there are orcs, as far as the skeletons are concerned.
All right, so I guess let's keep going, and Zing will actually glance over that. He'll try to see if he can recognize what's obviously over there.
Familiar-looking dirt area over here of where you guys climbed down, so you're pretty sure that's where that is.
Okay, so we looped all the way. So that's been established, okay. So then we would head down this way, and Lazarus would take the lead, but I'm going to proceed ahead because they're both AFK, if that's fine. Is everyone AFK?
I'm here.
Okay. Well, you can be my witness, but I'm going to assume Lazarus is in front of both of us.
Okay. Then
I would look down that way because we're still following our rule. Now go listen at the store.
You listen at the door. You do not hear any noises.
Open the door.
All right, in this room. Quick.
All right, I'm back. Did anybody find anything on the bodies?
No. There was nothing worth anything on the bodies found.
On the dead people.
We bodies? Also established that we have come around full circle.
Oh shit. Oh shit. Oh shit.
And you're basically assumed to be right behind me.
Yeah. I'm looking at all the bodies very carefully. Blackjack would also have detected magic on all the bodies.
There was no feeling of magic on those bodies.
You had said something about that we saw armor and stuff.
Yeah, it's rusted old bits. They're not worth anything anymore.
Zing is immediately drawn to this giant treasure chest in the corner back here.
Ooh. Okay, this chamber that you are in now was once an office or storeroom of some kind. A large stone counter that is that desk. Okay, this description is not entirely valid. It doesn't bisect the room. It does have three dusty balance scales made of iron sitting on it. There are cubby holes on the north wall filled with dusty paper scraps. There are several long dead corpses, gnomes and orcs by their look, are sprawled across the floor. The gnomes are the little ones.
Blackjack remembers his history, and he says, oh, I remember they were attacked by orcs. I feel really smart out of character.
Yes, there is a large lock iron strong box back there. It's very obviously locked. It has a big old lock on it. So,
is there anything on this broken chair?
No, there's nothing on the broken chair.
I take 5 minutes to take any broken pieces, put them in the brazier, and light the brazier.
The brazier is now lit.
I'm checking out this chest.
Yeah, I knew that. I was just doing that while you were
out. Yes, it's a box with a big hole on it.
I tried the keys on it.
None of your keys work.
Anything for locks?
It's got a key lock, but I don't know.
Blackjack tries the gold key.
Gold key is way too small for that hole.
Dang. Blackjack. Did the gold key open anything? Was I able to open anything? Okay.
You guys do not know what it goes to.
Yeah, that's fine. Examine this type of stuff.
It's mostly scroll. That scroll isn't legible anymore.
I checked the bodies in the room.
You check the bodies in the room for a key. Give me a perception check.
I see if you sift around stuff and sift through stuff, I think that's investigation.
You can use investigation to sift through stuff, yes.
I think used in the context of touching stuff, that's like if you're feeling for pressure, if you're like sensing.
You're perceiving, you mean?
In the other room, I was like, yeah, I think that's investigation, because I'm sitting just like tapping it and feeling texture and feeling tactile response. Like perception is like your 5 senses. That's why that one time I was like, I smell the air.
You do not find any keys on any of the skeletons.
There is the random chest.
Random, it's in the corner over there.
And a lit brazier.
I'm gonna try and...
Do you have a...
I have...
A crossbow.
This is what I'm using, yes.
Using a crossbow bolt, okay.
Do I see this?
I'm trying to pick the lock with that. You see actually break the bolt in the lock.
I lower my hat. Like, I take the front of it with my finger and my forefinger and my thumb, and I just pull it down and kind of... Under the hat, I do the face palm.
Huh. Guess it didn't work that time.
I look up and I say, Lazarus, I can get that pretty easily, very likely. We were looking for a key first so that we don't see too bad.
Well, should have said that first.
What's this next shelf or something on the wall?
That is some cubby holes on the wall with bits of dusty paper scraps in them.
I search that and see what I can find.
Can you read Dwarvish?
He's a dwarf.
Dwarf?
That is a good point. yes, you can see some faint markings on a few of the scraps recording weigh-in and disbursements.
That was my perception check, but I doubt that'll change anything.
Nope, that won't change anything.
How heavy does this thing look?
The chest?
Yeah.
Very heavy. Probably 50, 60 pounds, easy.
Okay, so I found nothing in here for sure, right?
You found nothing of use. You found some scraps with faintly legible words on them. Well, they weren't legible to you. They're in doors.
I searched the desk for a key. And I say, Lazarus, just hold up a minute, as I see him trying to lift it to determine how heavy it is.
That's true.
I have no idea, but I only have assumptions.
What are you using to search the desk?
I'm investigating the desk for a key.
Investigate the desk. Thinking to yourself, now where would I hide a key?
Well, I'm not just like, where would I hide a key, but I'm like looking over everything. And by looking over it, I don't mean just like using sight. I'm like picking things up. I'm moving things around.
Also,
I'm investigating.
Also, keep in mind, there's another room like right across the hallway. Could be in there too.
Could be in there. There's my investigation.
After searching through the desk for a while, you find in the back of one of the few, there's only like three drawers on the thing. You find in the back of one of the drawers a key.
Oh. Black Chick says, aha!
Oh, right. Did anyone need a healing gloves away or no?
Nah.
I that could one. Use it, but I'll be fine.
Not me, at least.
I self-cast.
You get health.
All right. Remember your short 16, your total health.
Yeah, it's his new maximum. His temporary maximum. Did I find anything else in the desk that's useful?
No, the desk was actually pretty much empty.
On the desk, I saw some scales. What else?
On the counter of the desk, there is three dusty balance scales made of iron.
Do they have anything on them?
Possibly. Yeah, there's some old weights.
Possibly. There's some what?
Some old weights that you would use to weigh things with the balance scales.
Oh, there's weights? Okay. And then Blackjack says, I have a concern, gentlemen. What did you say you found on those scrolls over there in the back, Albrecht?
What was it again? Like, out of character?
It was, oh, jeez. There it is. It is, some records of weigh-ins and disbursements.
They're records of weigh-ins and disbursements.
And I'm out of character. I'm assuming that means like weigh-ins of like ore and distribution.
Yes,
weigh-ins
of precious metal found and disbursements of where stuff went.
Okay. Black Chick says, I gotta think exactly how I would say it. So based on what you've read, Black, do you think 5% is a big enough cut? As Albrecht absorbs that, Blackjack goes over here and attempts to put the key in. And attempts to unlock the chest.
There's something in the lock.
I look into the lock.
There's a small bit of a bolt stuck in there.
I pull it out.
After a couple minutes, you manage to...
When I drop it on the floor. I said, was this yours?
Probably.
Okay. I open my trench coat and I pull out a little thing. Man, if you could see my if we could do the screen sharing whenever we get that, I would literally like pull it out of my vest here like Blackjack would, and I would show you my lockpicking kit. But
you have a key.
Anyway. Oh. He reaches into his vest and pulls out his key.
You literally had a key. You took the key, you tried it. You said, oh, there's something in there. I guess I should get my lock picking kit.
I know. I know, it's really funny. Okay, I put in the key and I open the freaking stupid thing.
It unlocks easily.
Yay! Blackjack lifts it and says, look what I found!
It's money!
That's all that's in there, just money?
Yeah, a fair amount of money, actually.
We split the money out evenly. Well, how much money is in there now? I'll take some money out just so that it is even. So like I won't get as much money just so that it's evenly distributed for everybody else. Cause that's what my process is. So how much money is there in there? How much? Any platinum?
There is. Here, I'm typing it out.
Oh, okay. Well, just to say, if you tell me one at a time for each different kind, I would split it out as you go.
Okay.
Okay. 50, 40. Okay. Everybody except for me gets 40 gold. I count out 40. Oh, shoot. That one's going to make it tough. Well, oh, well. Yeah, everybody but me gets 40 gold. And I get 36. Yeah, and then everybody...
taking the cut.
What?
But you're a gentleman taking the cut.
Well, taking the cut?
Yeah, you're taking the lesser share.
Well,
lesser
no, not quite. See what's going to happen here. I have to finagle some stuff. And then hopefully I will still end up with the shortest end of the stick. I've been doing that the whole time. And then everybody gets 60 silver. And then I will point out that there's this one platinum piece that I am taking.
All right. End up with it's worth 10 gold.
Yeah, I know. But
that works for me.
Dividing evenly to give everybody easy also. And then out of the rest of them, I give everybody else... Oh, hey, I did do right then, I think. Yeah, everybody else gets 100 copper because that's a lot of weight and I don't really want to carry it. Yeah, and you notice that I don't get any copper, but everybody else each gets 100 copper.
I don't want no pennies, you take. We have actually decided, I decided, and it made Arthur sense with what we were doing when I was talking with Arthur, is that basically one copper piece is worth about a dollar.
Holy, oh, well, oh, okay, yeah, I don't really, it doesn't really.
I know it doesn't really matter, but that's just kind of how we were arranging prices of things.
Okay. There's no such thing as pennies, you guys.
And a set of full plate costs 1,500 gold, which is, like,
massively expensive.
Why don't you just call it a gold is a dollar, and then, like...
Because that doesn't make nearly as much sense.
No, but it does in context. Like, so if you, say for instance, if you go back, it, like, our sense of a dollar doesn't matter, right?
Oh, if you really go back, yes, a penny would have been like a copper.
That's what I'm saying.
That's,
like,
that's kind of why pennies.
Time does not matter when applied to money. Money is only worth relative to what goods are being circulated.
We were talking relative prices between D&D items and real life items.
Oh yeah, I'd say copper is about like at this moment in dollar value. Yes, copper is worth about a dollar.
It's actually pretty close because
year 2000 2000.
It's actually pretty close.
Okay, so I do that thing.
Can I have the key?
Why do you want the key, Blackjack says?
Because I'm totally going to take that chest out of here and, like, put it on my cart later.
That broken chest?
Is this chest broken? Chest,
that iron chest is not broken at all. It's in very good condition.
Oh, it just looks in bad condition. My bad. Sure, I guess you can have it. Yeah, here you go.
Sweet!
You carry that 60-pound chest around with you?
Can I have the book?
I'm reading the book.
Okay.
He's holding up in one hand a 60-pound chest, and the other hand he is reading a book.
Seems
says,
fine.
I'm reading a book. Anyway, Blackjack says, by the way, I seem to forgot one thing that I wanted to do. Do you guys mind if we go back after we open that other door? Do you mind if we go back to the other that Wraith's room? I really would like to take another look at that chest. And out of character, I promise this is not me looking over anything. I really have no idea what I'm doing. But okay. Blackjack, in character, Blackjack says, with all the stuff in there that was in there, all the good stuff, it wouldn't surprise me if there's a secret compartment. And I, out of character, I was going to look, but I literally forgot. And so in character, he says, I just happened to forget. I thought about it, and maybe there's a secret compartment in there. But let's go to this other room first, of course.
Sure.
Oh, by the way, I like to look at the dead bodies to see if there's anything but bones there.
Those dead bodies?
Yeah.
There are some scattered remnants of clothing on the gnomes. One of them is wearing a ring.
I would like to detect magic on, or identify the ring.
You're using identify on it?
Yes.
It is a gold ring.
Okay. Blackjack picks it up and says, here you go, Zhang. And he tosses something shiny at you.
Zhang puts it on.
It doesn't fit on your hand. It's way too small.
Oh. It's an earring! Out of character.
Zhang puts it on his toe.
It is too small for your toes.
Zhang stares at it.
It's a ring that was made for gnomes.
Oh.
Gnomes are tiny, man.
Yeah, anything on the orc or the other dude?
There's orc. Old remnants of their armor and weapons.
I detect magic on the room.
You find no sources for magic in this room other than you and your friends.
Awesome.
Zhang is playing with the ring, trying to figure out how to wear it.
It is a simple, you know, looking at it, it is way too small to fit on any part of your body. Maybe you could make it into an earring or nose ring?
Yeah, that's what I was saying out of character.
Lazarus pushes open the door carefully.
You push open the door.
Shield at the ready.
Zhang actually braids it into his hair.
There you go.
Yep.
Ooh, I'd like to look and see if there's anything in this rubble with just a quick perception check.
Oh, okay, just a passing perception check. You don't see anything but rocks in there. It's obviously caved-in passageway.
All right, got it. You open the door.
You see a bunch of skeletons.
Shit.
The door creakily squeaks open. You see splintered stone benches and heaps of rubble from a partially collapsed ceiling in the back of the room back there. And amidst the ruined stone bunks and toppled weapon rack, there are the bones of several dwarves and orcs.
Orcs and dwarves, orcs and dwarves.
I step in.
Step in.
Yep.
What's this? Is that something?
What the? Oh, that's the. That is actually the lid of the barrel, I believe. Supposed to what?
Oh, okay.
And as you step further into the room...
Those are weapon racks over there?
That is a toppled weapon rack.
What about this?
These do... let's see. Yeah, those are weapon racks, but they don't have anything on.
Okay.
And as you step further into the room, You feel this odd breeze go by you, and the bones start to rattle.
Zingwax one of them.
Yeah, I'm just like smashing this one right in front of me.
Well, which one are you whacking, Zing? Three adjacent.
This one that's like face down. I want to crack him right in the back of the neck.
See, they're mashing that one. So you're mashing this one right here?
Yep.
Okay.
I also swing at the one in front of me.
Blackjack did not expect this, so he's not doing anything.
Well, they did say that there was going to be undead.
Yeah, the second they moved, Zing was just like, bah!
You actually see the bones pulling together.
What? I'm rolling initiative in any case.
I bought this one.
Give me a second. I forgot to put numbers.
This map is so freaking huge, guys.
It's like so crazy huge.
Yeah, but at least we like finally went around the whole outside of it.
This is a good adventure.
Okay, they have numbers.
The first yellow line is for the attack, the second one's for my initiative.
I'm going to first move them all to the token layer.
Bum 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 bum!
And then your attacks will happen.
Oh, shit. That's a lot of them. I don't have any more spells.
Okay, so... okay, so all of you who were attacking, let me see. Okay, Albrecht's first roll is his attack hit. Don't roll damage yet. Blackjack, were you attacking?
No.
No. Okay, so that's your.
Yeah, that's my initiative. That's pretty sweet.
Lazarus was an attack. You had advantage.
Huh?
Lazarus, your thing, was that an attack?
Yeah.
Okay, you hit. Jet.
Do you want damage?
I said don't roll damage yet.
Oops, I already rolled mine.
Okay. Zang, is that your initiative?
That was my attack, and I'll roll initiative now.
Oh. I do have some bad news for you. As you tried to stomp that skeleton, you slip.
That is my initiative. Here's my damage. If you're ready for that.
If you're ready for it.
No, I'm still not ready. Okay.
When I slip and fall to the ground, I pretend to be dead.
So are you just, like, boging your brains out right now?
You have to give me a deception check.
Nice recovery, though.
That is a good recovery. You are playing dead.
Yeah.
Okay, that is...
Can I see this? That this is a ruse?
You can still see him breathing.
Okay. Oh, uh-oh. I yell in the general area of the room. I don't know if...
There's not enough time.
No, I can
this is literally all happening in, like, a second.
I don't know if they can tell if you're dead or not.
Okay, so that...
There you go, Zang. Do you want my damage now?
Yes, I want your damage.
This much a bludgeoning.
Oh. As he pops up, you guys crunch him. He did. Again. For good this time. Hopefully. And let's see, he completely failed on his attack, so now it is the beginning of the encounter. Well, beginning of the encounter. Beginning of Blackjack's turn, that's what it is.
Okay, so Blackjack, that guy's dead, right?
Yeah, he just got dismantled by you guys.
Okay, Blackjack fires a crossbow bolt at this guy right here.
Let me pull up his skeleton.
With his magic crossbow. Dealing this much damage! As he steps
behind them. Damage.
As he steps behind them.
Okay. Then it's time for all the skinny men to go, or at least a few of them to go. There's a large difference between you and Lazarus, who is the next person. Okay.
Well, Admiral must roll really good initiative then.
Yeah, I did pretty good.
Yeah, Blackjack had 21 for his initiative.
So, like, I had 23, and everyone's going before me.
Wait, you did?
What?
Oh. How did I get that for you, then? You can go now, and you go now. Here, let me move you in initiative here.
I'm going to move up here and turn undead.
Oh, I see what I did. I wrote down your damage for your initiative.
Oh, yeah, no.
Okay, so wait, which guy? This guy?
I'm turning undead, so.
Okay, so what's the distance from you that it goes?
One sec, let me find it.
Because I know it's a distance. I think it's 5 squares. It's a distance. I can't remember what it is.
It's 30 feet, so 6 squares.
It's 30. Oh, it's 30 feet.
They have to make a wisdom saving throw.
They all have to make one, all 8 of them that are left.
Yep.
Wisdom saving? You're asking skeletons to make a wisdom saving throw.
Yep.
You sure you don't want to give them a con saving throw?
Can't even do that, so no.
I'm just saying that because they have a plus for that. 12?
13.
Okay, so, and they have to move away from you if they're infected.
They have to spend their turns moving as far away from me as they can, and they can take dodge actions if they can't move any further.
Okay.
It ends once they take damage, though.
I'm using the fear symbol. Pretty much what's giving them fear. It is not these guys' day. Yeah, sucks to have negative wisdom. Actually, it doesn't even matter if they had like plus 4 for some reason. 1. Does anybody get advantage on them or anything? Or is it just they have to
move? No, there's no advantage or anything. They just have to run and can't take reactions. For its action, it can only use the dash action or try to escape from an effect that prevents it from moving. If there's nowhere to move, the creature can use dodge actions.
It prevents it from attacking, too, though, right?
Yeah, all they can do is dash or dodge if they can't move.
Yay, how long does it last?
1 minute.
All right.
Wow. Or until they're hit.
10 rounds, or they take damage, basically. Okay, so that was your turn. And it's Skelly Man's turn, and you are there. He's gonna end up
Can I kick him as he's moving away from me?
Yes, you can.
I kick him with my staff.
Unsure how you do that, but okay. You successfully do that. You slap him with your staff for
Keep in mind that, yeah, I know they're undead.
Wait, so that last one's poison, right?
Yeah.
But it, I mean, you're bashing them with a staff, so I mean, that's better than stabbing them with a sword.
Yep, he's gonna die.
The sad thing is now, he's no longer afraid.
Yeah, well, actually, as soon as you hit him, he was no
longer. Yeah.
You realize he can hit you now.
I thought he'd go down easier than that, but...
Well, he's going to pick up the short sword next to him and smack you with it. He's a skeleton, so he doesn't have very good aim. So he misses you.
Yay!
Okay, this one's moving away from you.
He can't do anything about that one.
Oh, that's right. He already took his reaction.
I'm not going to do anything about the rest of them anyway, because I can't kill them in one hit.
Oh, let me just go ahead. You... And it's Lazarus's turn.
Is that a hole?
Where?
This.
That's a weapon rack.
That is a weapon rack.
Gotcha.
That has been destroyed by the ceiling falling.
I get in here, and I'ma smash that skeleton.
Which one?
The one that's not afraid.
Okay. You smash him.
Smash.
In fact, I think no matter what you roll, he will... Yeah. He crumples to the ground, the short sword rolls away.
And, Yeah, that's the end of my turn. He was behind me? Like
he was
here?
Right here. And he's moving up onto this table.
I'm a smack it.
Albert, you can attack him too.
From up there?
He moved away from you.
He moved away from you.
Oh, okay. I thought he was already starting up. Okay, yeah, then yeah, I'll swing at him.
Wait. I think I have advantage on that.
Why would you have advantage?
Let me just look.
The turn undead does not give you advantage.
But it makes them afraid. Like fear.
No, it doesn't.
There's no explicit fear, they just have to move.
I said it's like fear.
Fear.
Turn undead literally expels the undead, that's what it does. Just makes them go away.
Okay, well, he's not marked, so I can't use one of those special attacks. So I miss, probably.
You know, like in the movies, when somebody shows the cross and all the undead just go, and back away? That's kind of what it is. Compels you.
Except yeah,
in
pretty
this
much.
Case, it's your god.
Yeah, it's the power of Shantaea in this case.
Possibly a little bit of Lathander.
Yeah, a little bit.
Okay, so, Lazarus, you are unsure what's going on, so you miss. And Albrecht lands a clean hit.
Albert's probably going to just one-shot it.
He does, actually. As he tries to move away, you crush him in the back of the head. And it's Zhang's turn.
Ting finally stands up. Zhang goes, ew. Actually, no, he doesn't go, ew. Well, he does. He goes, ew. And that guy was already damaged, right? That's why he doesn't have the thing on his head.
No, he actually succeeded on the save.
He needs to die. So I'm gonna pop him a lot. I'm gonna spend my last key point.
Oh.
Six, no.
Oh.
When Zhang yells, "The dragon becomes me."
You know you don't have to actually spend that until, like...
Yeah.
Well, he hasn't actually spent it yet.
Okay,
he doesn't spend it until he makes that extra attack.
Because, I mean, we still have a lot of dungeon to go through.
Well, he gets them back every short rest.
Yeah.
Oh, every short rest.
Awesome. I can meditate for 30 minutes and get all of them back.
An hour.
Whatever.
And, let's see. You thwacking pretty good.
I'm not done yet. Bap.
Not down yet. You bap him a second time. Why do you have advantage?
I think I thought I was attacking the one that wasn't feared for some reason.
You're attacking this one right here.
Oh, well. Let me reroll that. Hang on.
Unless you changed your target all of a sudden.
No, I'm dumb. I'm gonna attack that one, and then I kept the roll that I was going to do the same. Sorry. Bap.
You still hit him.
Hey! I do that many bap.
Oh. Oh, you bap him to the ground. He isn't moving. Not anymore.
I turn around, I'm gonna bap that one.
Did you roll your damage without asking? Wait, no, you haven't rolled anything yet.
I'm doing my unarmed on the one I've got advantage on.
Yes, you need to roll the free.
Bap.
There you go. You bap him.
I do that many bludgeoning damage.
So what exactly were you hitting with your flit?
With my hand.
Hand.
Body chop in the back of the head.
Oh, he goes down. You hit him right on the back of the head, which knocked his head off, clean off.
Is a karate chop a slashing attack?
No.
Actually, no, that still would be bludgeoning damage because it's your hand.
Where did I start at when I started my crazy nonsense this turn? I was right here, right?
You started there, so you lost 20 movement standing down.
2, 3, 4.
20?
Yeah, movement isn't 15 movement, it's half your speed.
I thought it was... What?
Okay, so I used all my movement, awesome.
Nope.
Why'd you say nope, and so proudly?
Because we previously stated that it was 15 movement to stand up, and it's not, it's half your movement speed, whatever that is.
Okay, well I did...
Oh, really?
I only used half of it, I only moved 4 squares this turn.
I'm just stating that out loud so everyone knows.
Okay, thank you. I end my turn.
Okay. Oh, he's still alive.
Oh, it is that for speed, huh?
dead. No, I already got him dead. Okay. And back around to Albert. He should have gone first, not Blackjack.
I'll move in, hit the one that's, like, adjacent to me, not diagonal.
Okay. You hit. This is the second time you've done it. You hit the exact amount of damage to kill him.
Alright, that's the end of my turn.
That's literally the second skeleton you've done that to this round. It's hit the exact number. Okay, Blackjack.
Blackjack can't reach anybody, so he will... I think he's just going to go up. He's not going to risk not killing something in the first hit. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. His turn is done. He takes a dodge action, I guess. Yeah, that's it.
Okay. And it's Lazarus's turn.
That one that just moved, it's getting bonked. It is not getting the bonk.
Okay.
It has not been hit, technically.
Yeah, unless it takes damage, it's still turned.
Yeah, you can attack it as long as you don't actually deal damage to it. Zang.
Having a cleric just made this encounter, like, probably a lot easier than it probably would have been otherwise.
Bleh. I'ma whack it. Whack.
You whiff. The skeleton is cowering too closely to the rubble and you miss.
Zing kicks it. Wait a minute. I'm retarded.
I don't know what's with you, but your regular attacks have 4 rolls, and your bonus attacks all have really good rolls.
Well, you say that, but that happens.
I meant the attack roll, not the damage roll.
Like, I'm good at poking things.
However, this guy got about the shortest possible end of the stick. I'm serious.
That's hilarious. Awesome.
The shortest end of the stick.
Isn't your minimum damage like 5?
Yes.
God.
That's hilarious.
He died to 5 damage.
As I said, that skeleton got the shortest end of the stick.
I go there and in my turn.
Then it's all the way back around to Albert again.
I go here and try and bonk the one in front of me with my mace.
Ooh, he has taken the dodge action.
So that's disadvantage then?
Yep.
I believe so.
It is. He also gets advantage on reflex saving throw.
Well, that disadvantage didn't matter because you still clobber him.
Clobbered him pretty good, too.
You just do so much damage. Wait, what is the second kind of damage is the second Oh, that's your radiant damage.
Radiant, because they're undead.
Yep. That was number one. Guess how much health number one had?
13?
Yes. That is the third skeleton you've done that to.
Yeah, yeah!
I don't know what it is, but he's rolling the exact number to kill them.
It's magic.
Something. Somehow managed to cheat the dice.
I move into his space, and that's the end of my turn.
Oh, no. Blackjack, what you gonna do?
He's gonna try to get him! With a stabbity-stabbity swingy-slashy sword.
You stabbity-stab him.
Waha!
You stab him and actually you end up chopping one of, like, knocking one of his arms off.
Oh.
But he's still standing.
Oh, that sucks. Because you said something about 13 and I was like, alright. Anyway, that's the end of my turn.
It's his turn. Blackjack, he doesn't like you, so he's going to try to punch you.
He's going to get a shield.
Disadvantage.
Disadvantage on the punch.
What's your AC right now?
14.
He still hits you.
Dang.
For 2 damage, because he punched you. That's right, the skeleton just punched you.
Yeah, he's gonna die.
Well, it's Lazarus' turn, so it's probably gonna be he who kills him.
Bonk.
Yeah, bonk. He's dead.
Bonk.
It doesn't matter what you roll, he had 1 hit point.
Oh, man. That's lame.
Depressing.
Well, time to search the room.
Yeah.
You find some empty racks. I know they look like they have swords on them. They do not. That is a grinding stone for sharpening swords.
Okay. Yeah, the armor. I'd like to detect magic on all of this stuff right here.
All right. You're casting that as a ritual, I presume.
Yeah, I tell everybody, just a minute, I'm going to try to jig on this. Really, it's a much bigger space, so I'd like to just use it on the room if I can.
You can, sure.
Okay, detect magic in the room.
And Echo. The only magic you detect in the room is on you guys.
Okay.
And all the weapons are too old and messed up. The armor on that rack is basically barely hanging onto the rack, and there's like holes in it and stuff. It's, you don't even want to take it. It's not worth what it's made of right now.
What's this?
Those are benches.
Okay.
That is a grind. Don't think you're going to take the grind.
No. I opened this barrel to see what's in it.
There is nothing in the barrel.
I move these barrels here around to see if there's stuff in those barrels.
None of those barrels have anything in them.
I see if these crates have any weight to them.
One of the bottom ones has some weight.
Hey, Lazarus, as you roll by, like, what? I say, help me with this crate. It's got weight in it. I chuck the other box aside.
Lazarus, do you just want me to, like, pick it up, or, like...
I open it. Help me open it.
Hulk smash. Come on.
I apply a crowbar. I proceed to open it.
I assist him with my crowbar.
You both easily open the crate because you have crowbars. Pow!
What do we see?
Some hay.
It's stuffing. If it's just hay, I don't see any animals.
You see hay covering. You don't know.
No, I'm saying that out loud. Oh, Chris.
I will.
I'm not correcting the DM. I don't do that.
I will search through it.
You're searching through the hay?
I'll do the same, but while searching through it, I'm going to just, like, throw the hay onto the floor.
I get confused.
Why do you get confused?
In the middle of all that hay, there are some bars made out of metal.
Like ingots?
Yes, there are some ingots in there.
What kind of metal?
Are they?
Are you going to take them out of the box so you can get a good look at them?
Sure.
No.
There are 4 ingots.
That's a big box for just 4 ingots. What? Yeah, but what are they made of, like you said?
You need to determine what they are.
Are they platinum, gold... Electrum.
It is really obvious copper. They are not gold, electrum, or silver, or copper.
Okay. So these are not money. Okay. Huh. What color
Does
is it?
Look like iron?
They look like they're black.
They're black? Oh,
I'm gonna try and figure it out.
What check do I need to determine whether or not they're just obsidian?
With that check, what the hell are these things?
Oh.
Wait, why are you looking for obsidian?
I don't know, it's black.
I don't think that'd be an ingot, though.
Yeah, I don't think so either, but heck.
They are not obsidian.
Okay.
What are they, then?
Are they... What do you call it? Crap.
If that's an insight check.
Are they ebony?
No.
Is it clear?
No, they're black and made out of metal.
Chris, if that's an insight check, add +1 to that.
Well, okay, basically, you know this. They look kind of like iron.
Are they cold iron?
How are you going to determine that?
Well, I guess first you have to know what cold iron actually is.
That's a good point.
Yeah.
Which I've rolled.
Yeah, he knows what cold iron is.
Is that... How does one normally check for how cold iron is? Like,
are they magnetic? Take the...
Press your face against it. If your face gets stuck to it, it's probably cold.
That is not how cold iron works.
Blackjack puts his dagger or rapier in front of it to see if it sticks to it.
What's your rapier made out of?
Some sort of iron.
It doesn't stick.
Okay. It's not magnetite, guys. Blackjack says...
So it's some kind of iron, right?
I have no idea, Blackjack says.
I'm asking the GM.
You can also see, like, work marks all over these ingots.
I'm asking the GM. So it's some kind of iron.
Yes.
I'm going to compare it to the iron pot that I have. See if it's like the same kind of substance.
The magic iron pot?
Yes, Mike. The magic iron pot.
The reason I ask that is that going to change what you think of it, since now you've magicized your pot?
I honestly don't know. Okay.
It looks a little bit different. It's similar, but it is not the same to your pot.
And there's like 3 ingots of this?
He said 4, I thought.
There's 4 ingots of it. They each weigh 20 pounds.
Holy crap, it's the 3 that you didn't pick up. That's what you're counting.
Okay.
Holy crap. Is it lead?
No, it is not. Very obviously not lead.
Oh, it's not. I mean, how big are the ingots? Like, the bars for money in 5th edition are pretty small, actually.
These are a bit bigger than you'd think. There's a reason we're in a big old box.
But, like, what's the size?
Honestly, I don't know what size they would physically be.
I mean, are we talking, like, 6x2x2? Or are we talking, like, 12x3x4?
I have a really easy way to just, like, solve this.
To solve it? When...
Like, what these are.
Okay.
Why don't we just go up to the dwarves that are actual miners and stuff?
Oh, yeah, we could do that. Do you want to just leave it here because it's heavy and we can just ask them
I'd later? I'd say they're the size of a small loaf of bread. They're pretty big.
Well, it's about 12x3x4.
We could
a little bit smaller than that, but not much.
We could just go up there and like see if they're good and whatnot, because we haven't seen them in a while, and it's kind of dangerous here. They might think we're dead.
Okay, I'm good with that.
Yeah, checking in with them would be a good idea. We can tell them kind of what we found so far.
Yeah,
I get the lead or the ingots.
The questionably heavy ingots.
I put them in the box.
And he proceeds to
carry... I begin to carry away the box.
100 and...
I have the capacity for it.
130 pounds, just the box and ingots.
I have the capacity for it.
Blackjack lights these other things over here.
Zane just teleported. Okay, you can draw the little.
Okay. Yeah, I will.
I'm lazy, sorry.
They light up all the frescoes and they look neat.
As we approach here, do I see what's above me?
Oh, like, where are you? Oh, what's up there? Oh, yeah, yeah.
It's death!
Oh, holy cow. We keep that in mind.
Quite a bit areas you guys just haven't gone to.
I told you, the map is freaking huge, man. Like, it's just a zoom out. Zoom out of it, guys.
Here's a question. How are you going to get up there with that weight? Where are you?
Hey, Zing.
Yep.
You're still, wall walkie, right?
Uh-huh.
Can you carry this up there?
Yup.
One bar at a time, if needed.
Well, I mean, my strength score is currently 19, so...
He can carry it. He can just pick it up and just carry it.
No, I walk up the wall.
I just climb up.
Yeah, you can just climb up if you're not carrying that.
I give Zing a thumbs up.
Oh, you were carrying it up.
Zing gives a similar thumbs up.
They're burying him right there.
He hasn't built it. He's going to build a thing. He hasn't got there yet.
I thought that was a hole in the ground.
Well, it's not a hole in the ground. That's already filled in hole.
What?
Hey, guys. We're back.
It looks like an empty hole.
You see one dwarf. Oh, wait, no. I think I see two. You see two dwarfs. The other dwarf was in disguise. Okay.
What?
Dwarf formers.
Gundren looks towards you and says, "Oh, you're back. Have you finished exploring the caves?"
Oh God, no,
not quite.
God, no, no. We were just coming back to check up on you, see if you're good and all. I look over at the elf. What's going on?
Where's the sprite for the elf?
Right here.
Oh, there he is. Yeah, he'd be conscious.
Is he still alive?
We tied him to it. He is still alive, and he is conscious, and he's glaring at you guys.
And he's gagged and bound, so he can kiss my butt.
I kind of want to just, like, knock him unconscious again.
No,
but
too late. I already did. I punch him in the face to knock him unconscious. I really hate this. Again. I really hate this guy.
That's cool.
What did this guy do to you?
He exploded on them.
There is that.
He exploded on them.
He was trying to commit suicide. He failed.
So,
he was an elf?
Yeah.
One of the dudes?
No, he was an elf.
That was Spider. That was who that is. That's Spider.
Yes, yeah. That's Spider.
Oh, I thought he was a doppelganger. Okay, anyway. I have questions for him.
We're doing fine here.
Also, we found some ingots of something that kind of like iron. I'm thinking it's cold iron, but I'm not sure. Can you help check?
Well, let me see it.
I pull out a 20-pound ingot of some kind of iron.
And Gundren spins about 5 or so minutes glancing at it, tapping it with his hammer a little bit. A smaller hammer, not his weapon.
Ting, ting, ting.
And he comes and he walks back over to you and says, yep, this is definitely cold iron.
Called it. All right.
Now, that's 80 pounds of cold iron. That's worth a lot.
Yeah.
Blackjack says, he thinks about it for a minute, and he says, why would you have ingots of cold iron in a mine?
To deal with Faye.
To do what?
To fuck, like, Faye creatures up.
Yeah, but they're... Blackjack goes, ah...
This is also like a forge where they forge magical weapons, so a magical weapon forged out of cold iron would really fuck a fey creature.
Blackjack says, that's why I said,
that's not quite the case. You cannot, if you make a magic item out of a cold iron, it will lose the cold iron ability unless they're in an anti-magic field.
That seems... Okay, didn't know that. That's weird. Okay.
But we only saw... Blackjack pauses for a moment. We haven't seen anything to forge actual weapons yet. But we haven't explored the whole thing. Maybe there's a forge somewhere.
There is actually a rather large forge somewhere in here. At least it's been told of. Now, I don't know where it is.
Probably in the center. Like, we've kind of went around the outer rim so far.
So, what have you found?
Lazarus? Blackjack says.
Well, we got a new staff from, Spider. We found a fungus cave, which you don't really want to, like, go through, because it will poison the hell out of you.
A lot of Sturges, Blackjack says.
They're all dead.
Not terribly surprising.
They're all dead.
There's probably more in there somewhere.
We found some undead. We killed some undead.
We found a creepy eye thing that we dealt with.
Creepy?
Yeah, that was...
What did it look like?
It was like an eye beast.
Big floating eyeball. With eyeballs on tentacles.
Where was this eye beast?
He was way into the cave.
We basically did a big circle, I think, around the outside of the cave.
Ooh, we found where the echoes come from, where the name comes from of the cave. There's a big recess pool that may lead outside of the cave somewhere. I don't know.
Oh, wow. I didn't even know that.
Yeah, that's where those light boomings you hear are. It actually gets louder when you go in.
So what was this eye beast doing? Was it just hanging out somewhere in a cave?
It was guarding something.
What was it guarding?
It was guarding a room, and it said it was like kind of... And Zing kind of looks at Blackjack like, am I talking too much?
He's got the look of, oh my gosh, he's like, if his face could say, oh, so, like, I don't mean to insult your character. I have no good way of saying the look on his face of disappointment.
Well, Zane shrugs and just goes, whatever. It was basically set by some kind of old thing. And it was, like, just set to guard a perimeter. And we wanted to see what it was guarding, so we beat the hell out of it.
So you killed this eye beast?
Yeah.
Banished it?
Oh, so it was a summoned creature. Oh.
Yeah.
Summoned by an old wizard that apparently used to work on the Spellforge here.
Oh, so did you find the Spellforge?
Yeah.
Maybe. I think that's what it might have been.
Well, I mean, believe there would be a large flame associated with it.
A large green flame that...
That doesn't burn you?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, we found that.
Yeah, so then you guys have found the old Spellforge. Is the flame still functional? Do you know?
Yes,
I tap my shield.
Yeah, we kind of your shield. Kind of put all of our stuff in it, and all of our stuff's glowing now, so I think it's working.
Well, I can tell that the energy is dissipating out of these items, so it might not be working quite right.
Yeah.
It's probably old, but there might be something we can do to fix it. I don't know.
Well, I don't know if you can fix it, but I bet we can find a way. It might take some time, though, of course.
Yeah.
I'm not sure myself.
I'm going to put this on the back of my cart now.
Oh, that chest you're holding there?
Yeah. It's kind of heavy.
That chest you charged through a room with skeletons with?
No, I didn't have it then.
Oh, no, you didn't. You'll pick it up?
Yeah, I just picked it up.
Oh. Well, all right. As far as I know, your cart's where you left it.
Okay. I give a thumbs up and I head that way.
Your cart is where you left it.
I put the chest on the back and, like, lash it in properly so it's actually, like, functional there. And I eventually walk back. So, that's 80 pounds of cold iron.
Now I'm trying to figure out why they had it here. They only affect Fae, the undead, and fiends.
Well, I mean, there's like a shit ton of undead here.
Well, yes, and that's also a question, is why are there undead here?
There was a wraith, too, that like tried to suck Albrecht's life out of him.
Whoa, where was his wraith?
Like right beside the Spellforge.
Oh, I think I might know what have happened then.
He was probably the one who summoned the Eye Beast.
Yes, that's my thoughts.
Yeah, the entire room.
He was
summoning
the Eye Beast. The
entire
killed.
Room.
And then he came back as a wraith to avenge himself. But,
well, he's dead now.
He stuck around.
He's dead now and doesn't have any hands.
He doesn't have any hands?
Nope, we kind of cut them off.
Out of character.
Why would Zane, you cut off his hand?
Because it was fun. Hey, you know what? Let's go explore the rest of the cave.
Well, he was trying to give people the bad touch, so we cut off his hands.
Yep. That's what we did.
Out of character, the one thing you lie about.
Well, it was obviously an excuse, so it's not really a bluff.
But no, it was the truth. He was trying to give them the bad touch.
So we cut off his hands. Well, we didn't. Someone here did.
Well, I hope you guys can help clear out this cave, because once it's functional, 5%? Or what was it? No way, you each got 3% apiece, right?
Yes. Yeah, we did.
No, I'm asking. I am asking this, not Gundren.
It was 10%.
No, it was 5% for everyone, if I'm not mistaken.
No. Each person got 2.5%.
Yeah.
Really? Yeah, that's what it was.
Okay. I'm good with that then, because I had thought it was only 5% for everybody, because I thought everybody had talked them down.
No.
I tried to talk them up, and then everybody's like, oh, no, that's good enough. You shouldn't really talk. And I was like, well, and then I failed my role really bad anyway.
So each of you are getting 2.5%.
Okay, that's fine.
Total of 10%. I think you guys are going to make a killing once you finish killing.
Such a great joke. So do we want to take like a... How's everyone feeling in
feeling
terms
pretty
of...
good.
I could use a quick rest just to get my like breath, and then we can get going.
Because I mean, Albrecht still has like major fucked up right now, and we've just been like taking a ton of short rests. So like, actually sleeping might be a okay thing.
Would we level up if we slept?
Yeah.
Yes, we would.
Okay, you know what? That's not a terrible idea.
I need to give you a little bit more experience than if you're going to sleep. As in, give me a second here.
Yeah, if we're going to level up, then that's definitely worth it.
Like, Albrecht's down like 16 health, like, permanently until we sleep.
I'm completely out of heals.
Everyone's out of spell slots.
We're kind of running on empty.
I mean, I can still fight, because just give me like a short rest and I get like 15 different heals back, but like...
Something for that.
I mean, same thing with me. My damage comes back, but...
I get my channel, but that's about it.
I'm gonna stop blowing my heals. I need to save mine for emergencies if I've only got 15 points.
Well, when you level up, you'll have 20.
Still, it's not as big of a pool. I was kind of using it a lot.
On the upside, do you know what most of us get at level 4?
Yeah, finally.
2 stat points.
God, that's gonna be so good for me.
Four feet.
I'm definitely taking the 2 stat points.
I'm seriously debating between like taking Shield Mastery and doing something with my bonus action, or getting +1 strength and +1 comp.
Dude, if I were you, I would just take the bonus action, because you don't need any more. You're usually hitting, and you're not dying right now, so I mean, you'll get extra hit points anyway.
Well, yeah, but it's like, wait now or get a 6 level.
Oh wait, I didn't give you guys all the other experience you got either.
No,
we have not gotten any EXP since we've come in here.
You guys are going to get a butt ton of experience here.
Yeah, I was in my mind, I was like, I'm good to keep going until we need sleep, because we can always come back here, and it's like...
Well, I'm saying this because there's a shit ton more undead. There's a shit ton more undead, probably.
Yeah.
Our cleric's kind of fucked up.
I would play it safe. I mean, we can level up. It's a huge boost, and we can just pile drive through the rest of this place.
So you guys, what are you guys at right now, experience wise?
I don't know.
We are at 2,225.
Well, you're definitely gonna be over level 4 then.
We have not gotten any EXP since we started in here.
You haven't got any experience for anything in this cave.
Yeah, I know. We did 1, and, 2,
but you've done a lot
3,
of encounters.
4.
We've killed 1 orange jelly.
5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 7 4, encounters, 5. And we could have probably done 2 more, I think.
5 bugbears, 2 doppelgangers.
Where were the bugbears?
There were 3 that we kicked off of a cliff.
Yeah.
And then the 2 in the main room.
In the boss room, yeah.
4 giant spiders, 2 doppelgangers, the elf.
And a partridge and a pear tree.
That's what I was thinking like 5 minutes ago.
A spectator, a wraith, like 10 surges, 10 skeletons.
Arthur.
Like, we have just murdered everything.
Stop talking, Arthur.
Why? He's not... I mean, you're still doing stuff.
No, I have the number ready.
Oh, okay.
Okay. EXP.
Everybody gets 1,400 experience.
That puts us at 3,625.
Does that happen to put us at level 5?
No, no. Level 5 happens at 6,500.
Finally, because I like just the whole leveling up is like painful on me because it's a lot of work, and I'd rather just stick at a level for a while.
It starts slowing down now because this next one's 6,500. The one after that's 14,000.
I hope so because I just want to stick at a level and figure out all of my spells and abilities.
Well, basically, it's kind of a mad dash to get the 4, and once you're there, it slows down a lot.
Yeah, I hope so.
No, I mean, looking at just not just the numbers, but the way other things are arranged.
I get so much stuff now. Holy crap.
Well, yeah, bards get a lot.
Okay, so we're level 4, yes?
Yes, if you've already leveled yourself up. Do any of your stuff that I have recorded change? Do your perception or insights change?
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah. All right.
Yeah. I got to determine what skills I want to train.
Once you have those numbers, tell them to me. Don't have them yet, that's fine.
My perception's 14, or my passive wisdom in general is 14.
Same.
So, well, you were 13, 15 before, what are you now? Albert.
What? Like, my modifier is 4, I'm at 18 wisdom now. So, insight would be,
your perception 6. And insight. That...
Yeah, perception 4, insight 6.
So, 14 and 16 then. Okay.
Now, when I up my constitution, I get HP for each level before that when it's a new modifier, yeah?
Yes. Yes, you do. Okay. It is retroactive. And if you lose your constitution, you lose health. So if something damages your constitution, you lose health.
Well.
Also, you have all of your health back because the long rest. You gain... Well, since you're level 4 now, you get 2 hit dice back. Okay, so Lazarus rolled his health.
Oh, no, that was actually just for healing.
Well, that was your healing, okay.
Like I did that out of character. I know you don't really mean it, but it's still funny.
No, that was, I think that was the wrong number, actually, wrong die.
That one's my health.
That's not bad.
Wait. Oh, shit, yeah. I was like, how do you have a plus 5? Oh, yeah, shit.
Hill Dwarf plus 18 con.
So much con and wisdom. So silly. How much health do I get this level? So, Chris, can we ask for you to re-roll that?
I believe I said I wasn't going to do that again.
What Arthur's saying is you said you weren't going to do that again.
Please?
I believe I said I wasn't going to do that again.
Now, Arthur, you say you believe it.
Yeah, I mean, I take a reroll on mine since I rolled the 1, but I'm fine with it if you're not doing that.
I am not doing that. That means 2 people who rolled a 1.
Yeah, I just really like to have more than 4 health from a level up.
It's fine. I got 5, so...
No,
yeah, but...
Okay, so Albert got 6 health. Zane got 5 health. Lazarus got 4 health. Cool.
All right, we're the best. Do I roll a d8? What's mine again?
Because I know somebody else knows what I do. I believe it's a d8 for Bard, I believe. Yeah.
Yeah, the only people that get, like, d6s are, like, sorcerers.
Yeah, your hit die is a d8. D8 plus your con.
All right, here you go. /R1d8. We're going for all ones, baby. All ones, here we go.
That number so, plus your con.
Yeah.
What's your con?
0.
So 6, 5, 4, 3.
Yep.
Oh, I got the lowest. But I got below average, but it's not, like, really bad. It's only
I rolled a 1 on the D10.
Everybody got below average.
I rolled a 1 on the D10.
I mean, my total health is not that bad.
Technically, Zhang had the best roll.
Holy crap, I have so many
things. Well, no, both of you had the same roll, so...
And all of a sudden, I know how to do everything.
I think you'll find that not getting as much health isn't as horrible as you think.
Yeah, and I rolled 8s both last times, so this sort of equals it out a bit.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking. I rolled pretty high for my last ones. I'm at 23 health. So
well, okay. Every time you roll a 1, you'll roll a high number too, so yeah.
Maybe. Maybe.
Hopefully.
Well, so we sleep overnight.
Yeah.
Actually, it was in the mid-afternoon when you guys got back to his cave there, because of all the short rests.
Yeah, like, actually, it was probably later than that.
I don't care. You guys figure
out. It was late enough.
And what do I get for today? Womp, womp, womp.
A piece of pie in your pocket. You don't know how it got there.
No. That's for recharging the wands.
I get a
Well, you have to roll each wand individually that is missing charges.
Yeah, we only have one wand.
Oh, that's right. You guys only have one wand. You have other devices, though, but I don't think they're missing any charges.
Zang's staff is.
Then Zang needs to roll to recharge his staff. The spider staff, I believe.
Yeah, just a sec.
It's like a D6 plus 4.
I don't know.
Looking.
The spider staff is not in the Dungeon Master's Guide.
I got it.
That was a bard spell. I didn't know it was a second level spell.
The entire staff is recharged.
Yeah.
I only spent 4 points that day, so.
So, the new day has come, and it is the 27th.
2 days remaining. Wait a minute. No, that's the wrong game.
4 days remain.
Before what?
Who knows?
Before the end of the month?
Yeah.
Okay, Zing's gonna try something interesting. He's gonna go over here after he eats his morning ration, and he's just gonna jump.
You jump really high. You jump much higher, much higher than you used to.
Wait, why?
Because I say so.
Okay.
There's no reason he can't be attuned.
Anyway.
What's he missing? He doesn't have his boots of striding and sprinting.
Wait, you don't? Who has those?
Those are mine.
The dwarf.
Then the dwarf can jump high.
Yes.
I've had those attuned for a little while.
I jump straight down into the pit, and I don't, like, climb down.
Oh, yeah, he has slow fall.
I want to see how it works.
Well, let me look real quick.
Well, you still take the falling damage, but you reduce it by 5 times your monk level. So.
Yeah.
So, a 2d6 minus 20.
Yeah. That's what I was thinking.
Yeah, basically, if the damage is less than 20, you can just ignore it on for falling.
Cool.
If the max damage is less than 20, then no roll needs to be made.
Yeah.
So up to a 30 foot fall, you don't have to worry about. Anything above that, you do.
Well, and even if he has acrobatics, he can also make a check too.
But he still has to make that check then.
Well, yeah, but.
But yeah, you can make the check before rolling happens, because otherwise the rolling is pointless.
All right, I'm gonna make a note. 3 foot fall, ignore damage. That's 6 squares, right?
No.
Yeah, that 30 feet is 6 squares. Yeah. Yes.
Okay, I need to keep that number in mind. Thank you.
Okay, so Lazarus looks kind of chipper. The dwarf probably doesn't look nearly as dead as before.
He has regained his vitality.
Lazarus just climbs down. So we probably slept for like, yeah, we needed to swing by the Spellforge again.
I make my mace glowy if it wasn't already.
If you never told turned it off, it stayed on.
Then it's still on.
We all ready to go?
Yup.
Can we just, like, do a quick travel and just, like, cut down the time this takes and just say that we go to the Spellforge and, like...
You can. You guys can get there. You've already pastured those areas.
Okay, can we... Let's just enhance our stuff and get on the road again.
Cool. Okay, so we all teleport to the Spellforge.
We check our shit.
My ritual that I choose, comprehend languages.
Don't you get second level spells today? Or now?
I do. I already got a second level spell. I also get comprehend languages.
Huh. Oh, right. You third level bard, you.
I also get other stuff. I also get the stupid cutting words. So I get to use reactions for stuff now. So let me write that down. I get, like, everything this level. I get, like, 8 different things. I'm serious, you guys. I get a second time expertise. I get 3 additional skill trainings. I get ritual casting. I get cutting words. I get a second level spell level, but really one of those things is just from
Wait, didn't you already have ritual casting, though?
Oh, no, I don't get ritual casting this level. Dang, never mind. Forget what I said about comprehend languages. I just realized something.
Wait, when do you get ritual casting?
4th level bard. I'm at 3rd level bard. Don't worry about it. I made a mistake. Alright, we're there. I will use my perception to pat down the box and look for secret compartments and things.
I mean, I can't find it.
What?
Where you learn ritual casting as a bard?
It's a feat.
Yeah. Taking that as my 4th level feat. Okay. So I look in the box, and I've got baller perception now. More baller than 4. But I'm going to take a bunch of time, basically. I'm taking a lot of time. Why did we go that way? Where are we now? We're not over there.
You said you were going to the forge.
No, he said it was near there, I thought.
No, we're going to the forge to read.
Oh, to items. Yeah, glowing, awesome. Yeah, all of our stuff is magical. Everything is magical. And then I say, I'll be right back. And I go to this chest, because that's where I was.
You notice after doing this, the flame is a bit smaller.
Like, after ours, or, like, after, like, the first one, or, like, after many?
After you've done, like, 3 or 4 items, you notice the flame's a bit smaller than it was.
We'll stop after that. I would have just done my shield, because that's super easy to...
I would have done my armor, because doing my staff doesn't do anything.
So basically, after we three got armor, shield.
I already said I do my stuff.
Oh, yeah. Like, Blackjack ran off, so.
Yeah, I did the stuff, and then I ran back towards this chest, because I want to search the chest.
Okay. And that's your perception check?
Yep, but I'm going to take as much time as I can.
After searching for 15 minutes or so...
I'm patting the box, because I don't know. I feel like there should be something, but...
You do not find any hidden compartment.
Okay. There's no compartment. Eventually, I get back to the other people.
Okay, so we went the all left route.
We don't want to go the all right route now.
We don't, because that'll...
It doesn't really matter, just pick a way and we'll go.
I think we should just go from here, so let's go this way.
We could... Or up by the river or lake, but okay, here's fine.
Give me a second.
By the way, you guys noticed that Lazarus is a lot more handier with a shield now. Like, you seem like reflects, like, probably like whenever he was sleeping, or not sleeping, but like during the long rest, since it's not all sleep, that he was training a bit with it. Like parrying attacks from like a phantom opponent. Shut up, Jacob. Shut your phone.
So you guys can move.
Oh, didn't see.
I'm just generally waiting for other people to...
Stop right there, please.
Oh, no!
You see things. And things see you.
Hello, thing.
That is not what I meant to do. That is not what I meant to do.
Oh.
That doesn't reveal anything. Let's, try this again, maybe, without just revealing bits of rock?
Huh.
Fuck is that?
I'm not saying huh to that.
The fuck are those?
Those are zombies.
Oh.
Well, okay, those... Corpse with flesh on? Corpse with flesh off.
Head on, apply directly to the forehead?
No, they all have heads.
That looks like a forge.
That one place that we didn't really check. Yeah, that totally had the forge in it.
The one place? Like, there's like 8 places that we didn't go.
And there's some billows.
Billows?
Yeah, you see the zombies. The zombies aren't paying any attention to you guys.
Oh.
Just want to, like, walk back the way we came.
I mean, we're going to have to clear this out eventually.
Yeah, but eventually doesn't have to be right now.
Why not?
Let's just take them out. They're just zombies.
Yeah. Okay, I'm just going to...
Wait, surprise. Let's surprise them.
That skeleton over there. He shall be my target.
Do you say that?
I pull out a wand and I'm okay. Saying that.
I'm gonna aim at this guy. I'm waiting on everybody. I say to them, do we need like a signal to do this?
You'll know when to attack.
I can see
that. That doesn't really...
When Lazarus shoots, I'm going to charge this one.
I'm shooting this guy.
And once he shoots, I'm gonna Sacred Flame. That one.
This one?
Yes.
Okay.
1, 2, 3.
And that skeleton's being shot.
Yeah, and the other guy's being shot too. Alright!
And I'm gonna do that.
And I have Sacred Flame. And it's a 14 save now, not 13.
Okay, well... Give me a second, because I have to process all of your attacks. Okay, so, first, Lazarus shooting the skeleton. What is that 3d4?
Magic missile.
Magic missile, magic missile. That's a pretty good use of magic missile.
And what was the roll before that?
My initiative.
Oh, I didn't roll initiative yet. I should do that.
I didn't think.
All right. Sweet.
Okay, so he automatically takes.
Expertise. I'm an expert in stuff. But I'd rather just have ability scores, I guess.
I can raise them next level.
Because with expertise, I get plus two instead of just plus one.
Okay, but instead of ritual caster, you could get higher stats.
Yeah, but I'm not power gaming. I'm gaming to have fun. I am power gaming in a way. I'm trying to my character.
Okay, so that's him. He takes that.
It'd be nice to rather than have a 2, 2, 1, 1, 0, negative 1.
Okay, Blackjack, you're shooting that one.
For a lot of damage, this guy.
You easily hit him. What was that first one? Oh, that was with advantage.
Yeah.
And let's see. Do a lot of. But he does not go down.
Oh, dang.
Then Albert.
Yeah, he's gotta make a whiz save. Or dex save.
He has to make a dex. What was the DC?
14.
He fails.
I think, am I attacking now?
If he's still alive.
Yeah, you can go ahead and charge.
I don't know what I get for charging, but I do it.
You have disadvantage, but you have advantage, so you just roll.
He doesn't have to charge, he takes a full turn.
He said he was charging.
Yeah, but... What he views as charging is not what you view as charging. He's not taking a double move.
So
he is via RP charging, but not mechanically.
Yeah.
Then you have advantage.
I don't think he's aware of the thing that you ruled.
I'm confused, but it's fine.
You hit him. The thing that I rolled is if you're using that charge move now, you have disadvantage on your attack if you're charging.
That makes sense. It doesn't make sense to get like a bonus for it because that's just overpowered.
No, it's not because fighters actually get that as a combat maneuver or can get that as a combat maneuver. You can actually get two if you take a feat.
Oh, because of your attack, he goes down. Actually, I think you had advantage anyway because of Sacred Flame.
No.
That doesn't give advantage.
That doesn't give advantage?
That's not
astral. For a cantrip, but no, it's just 1d8.
It's still my turn, right?
Oh, it just does damage.
That's not astral seal or anything.
Yeah, it's still your turn.
It's guiding bolt.
6, 7, 8.
Yes!
Oh yeah, technically I can move, can't I?
You could have if you already did the thing.
I mean, yeah. No reason not to.
Do I hit him?
Yes. Zombies have no AC.
I pop him for that much.
Alright. That particular zombie also goes down. You guys took down two zombies.
I did something, yay.
Which zombie? You killed number 7 and number 8. And I'm just gonna light up the whole area now.
Is it bright in there or what?
Actually, I believe the forge is emitting light of some kind, but I'm not sure if it's brighter. But there's no reason for me not to reveal since you guys are fighting.
Man, I am glad we did not go through that other door.
Which one? The one that leads into what I think is a canal?
Yeah, because that would have been... What? They would have been basically on top of us.
Oh, okay, holy so let me...
Yeah, that's crazy.
Oh, wait. What
this
was...
is cool.
Zane, what was your initiative? Let me look up here. Did you roll initiative, Zane?
No, I didn't. I'm dumb.
Albert did. And Blackjack did as well, I believe, right there. Yeah.
I did what?
We can roll initiative.
Yeah, I did pretty good.
Of the players, you did the best. Huh. Oh, jeez. Apologies for the wait. But, well, you see, there's more than two enemies. I should say more than two types of enemies.
I was going to say, yeah, you're right, there are more than two enemies.
It's more than just zombies and skeletons. You see, out of the top of the forge, out floats a flaming skull.
Lord. Shoot.
And it's the flaming skull's turn.
Shoot it. Zing ducks preemptive.
It is currently shedding a whole bunch of light. And I have to read it because it has a very long amount of stuff. Even though I've read it before, it has a lot of stuff.
He's gonna fuck someone's day up.
He opens his mouth. And three energy blasts fire out right at Zane.
He does what? Where
he's
is
shooting.
He? He's at the top?
He is floating above the forge. In the very middle there, that little square in the middle there.
Okay.
This is a spell, right?
He is shooting magic missile at you.
Is this an attack roll or is it automatic? It's
magic. Shooting the magic missile.
Okay. Okay, yeah, I'm not going to do anything. Sorry.
Do I just get fucked by it because it's magic missile?
Because it's magic missile, yes.
Okay,
unless you are immune to magic missile or have something specifically that says it won't do magic missile won't do anything.
It's three different attacks, right?
It is technically a ranged weapon. No, it's a spell. It's a spell.
It is a ranged spell.
I'm going to do something.
What's that?
I can use the feature after it makes it roll, but before it does damage. All right, I want to know what those damage rolls are first, because I get to bard. I get to use cutting words, and it basically says I can choose to use the feature.
I can choose to use the feature after it makes the roll, but before you determine the result.
This doesn't have a roll.
Yeah, for damage, right?
No, that's for the attack roll.
No, I'm saying, does it not have a damage roll?
No, cutting words is for the attack roll.
No, it's also for damage rolls. Keep reading. It's before damage, and I can... Sure. Or damage roll, you can use your reaction. Yes, I can use it.
Okay, yeah, you can use it specifically on the damage rolls.
Yes, so I'm being a healer, so
okay,
how much...
So
what are the three
says,
different rolls?
Oh, here's what it says.
I need to know the D4.
To spend one of your bardic inspiration rolling bardic inspiration and subtracting the number rolled from the creature's roll.
Yeah.
Where does it say you get to roll is?
You can choose to use this feature after the creature makes its roll, but before the DM determines whether an attack check succeeds or fails, or before the creature deals its damage.
Yeah, how does that mean you get to know the numbers?
Why would I even do that before anyway?
No, what I'm saying is why do you get... You're telling me to tell you numbers. Why do I have to tell you the numbers?
Because otherwise there would be no point for that statement in there.
But before the DM determines whether the attack roll or ability check succeeds or fails, or before the creature deals its damage, so you get to... lower its damage, but you don't get to know it.
Yeah, there is zero reason for you to know how.
But then
that does.
No, that does. I'm saying that before I say attack hits four or whatever.
But already covered by the rest of it. He's making an attack roll, ability check, or damage roll. You can. Blah, blah, blah.
It's mostly just so that you can't just go, oh, well, this guy crit you and did, like, 20 damage, and then you go, no. He did 6 less. You have to, it's a gamble. That's what it is.
No, I totally disagree, but I'm not going to use it. All right.
I still don't know why you think you'd know the number.
Because otherwise that statement wouldn't need to be in there. I disagree, but keep going.
No, that's, I mean, I don't understand your logic here.
I don't either.
Do you want to talk about it? Is that what you're saying? I don't want to hold this up.
I'm just saying that statement does not imply you would know anything.
I still disagree. I mean, I'm at agree to disagree.
I don't.
Where does it say that?
I don't know how you would possibly have any logic agreeing with that, is what we're saying. It's okay, but this is like, what the hell?
I'm still agree to disagree. I'm going to look at the meantime. Like, say agree. The thing here is ignore on.
Okay, well. Then you take damage from magic missile.
Okay. Zingo's little bastard.
Okay. What you enemy? Blackjack's turn. Oh yeah, you certainly curse it out because talk is a free action to a degree. I would agree because else someone will have this soliloquy in the middle of combat and that doesn't work.
The D&D version of filibustering.
Yeah.
It is Blackjack's turn.
Stop looking that up for a minute, Mike.
I did.
No, I mean, it's your turn.
Wow, you're really just like, yeah, I heard it's my... As soon as I heard it's my turn, I started looking at the board. I fire an arrow at this skeleton. Holy crap, man.
You strike the skeleton.
There you go.
He did. He crumbles to the ground. think you hit him last time. Yeah, you did. You're the one who sniped him.
No, I hit this guy last time.
Someone.
Lazarus hit him with magic missiles.
That's what it was. Lazarus sniped him. Okay. Zombie type. What's their speed? Probably like 2. He's coming for your flesh.
I angle my rod at him and spin it.
Your rod blocks his arm.
Yay!
It's Albrecht's turn now.
Can you Sacred Flame that skull, please?
I mean, I could hit it with something stronger than Sacred Flame, but... Can
two
I delay
rocket
my...
launchers at it!
So if I delay my action, I can take it later in the round, yeah?
Yep.
Yes.
Okay, then I'm going to delay for now.
Okay. You're... delaying. Okay. So many months. Coming at you with his rusty short sword. You run out in front, expect to get hit. Except this guy sucks.
Staff's been.
He. Oh no. He hits his zombie friend. And he hits his zombie friend. And he does. He does max damage to his zombie friend. Where are you? Where are you? They're coming around the mountain. Just for you guys. Skeleton walks into view. And he takes his bow. His short bow. And he aims it. At you, Zang!
Do it, you bitch, do it!
He shoots the dead guy in front of you. Just goes thop. Lands right in him. And it's Lazarus's turn.
Hey, Mr. Skeleton. And Lazarus shield bashes him. He needs to make an opposed athletics or acrobatics check.
Wait, the skeleton?
Yeah.
He's going for acrobatics. What's the number he's going against?
Against mine.
Yeah, that's why I was asking you to roll. You just rolled. Okay. Ha! He leaps out of the way nimbly.
And he leaps right into my staff. Does that hit?
Yes. Yes, that does. None of these guys have very high AC. A
21
will hit.
He takes that much bashy damage.
That much bludgeoning damage. Oh no.
And I growl.
You knock off his shield arm.
And I growl at him, and if he's not immune to fear, he's marked. I don't know if skeletons are immune to fear, but if they aren't, he's marked. That's the end of my turn.
Okay, I'll go ahead and take my turn now.
Oh, that just after seeing the roll.
So how far away is that skull?
Wait, okay, so just a second. Back to the game here. What just happened?
I'm trying to see how far away that skull is.
One, two, three, four, five, six. The highest he'd be up is six, so that's 30 or 35, because he's either 30 or 35, because he's between those two squares.
I'm trying to figure out something here. He's currently 20 feet up.
Okay, then yeah, I'll just shoot Guiding Bolt at him.
Pew, 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 pew. Oh, sweet. He gives me a target.
Here. This. You guys should be able to see that 20 beneath in there.
Oh, that's really cool, dude.
I just said show the name and made so everybody can see the name.
Oh, so, you made it. Okay.
That might hit something. It's probably not going to hit him. It might hit something.
Oh, jeez. And that was Guiding Bolt.
Yep. It was only his level one, but it's still Guiding Bolt.
You accidentally shoot it straight ahead. You need to roll the attack again. Wow. Lazarus, I'm sorry.
He does have a 21 AC right now, doesn't he?
Wait, what's his AC right now?
21.
How is it 21?
I still have magical shit. And I'm also wielding the staff.
And you managed to barely deflect the barrage from right behind you.
Okay.
I barely nearly just hit you with a Guiding Bolt.
No, you did hit him with it. He just blocked it.
Well, yeah.
Shield mastery!
That's the end of my turn, I guess.
By the way, Chris, is that one guy marked or no?
This guy?
Skelly? Yeah.
Yeah, Skelly Man be marked.
Okay.
That was Albrecht's turn. It's Skelly Man's turn. He's going right for you. It's...
Who? Me?
Yeah, you.
Put my shield in the way.